Acts the 10th chapter. And today, our focus is Jesus Christ is Lord. Any believers in the house? Hallelujah. One of my favorite hymns during this time of the year is He is Lord. The author writes, He is Lord, He is Lord, He is risen from the dead, and He is Lord. Goes on to say, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. This particular hymn helps to set the tone of the Lordship of our Savior Jesus the Christ. The writer helps us to understand the season of the Christian year, where our Savior gave up His life on an old rugged cross for the redemption of all humanity and the believers in the house. Even though He experienced the pain, the agony, humiliation of mockery and shame, our Savior endured the cross to help all of us understand the deity of our Savior. Yes, there have been many who have tried to duplicate the Savior of the world, but He has proven over and over again that He is Lord. Any witnesses in the sanctuary? As one writer stated, Jesus Christ in His Lordship, He is God's Son and our Lord. In His humanity, He was a descendant of David, and in His resurrection, through the Spirit of holiness, He was declared to be the Son of the living God through His resurrection from the dead. Our Savior Canaan, Jesus the Christ, He teaches us that He is Lord. Even though He spoke these words over 2,000 years ago, we must have faith to believe that His words are trustworthy. Peter, in his discourse in Acts the 10th chapter, wants us to truly understand this morning, this Resurrection Sunday, that Jesus the Christ is Lord. This sums up the central message of Christianity, that Jesus the Christ has been given a name that is above every name. Hallelujah, I hear witness in the house. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, and every tongue shall confess that He is Lord. Anybody here agrees with the word this morning? Somebody ought to say thank you. What should we learn from this pericope? 3 points this morning. First of all, we need to understand on this Resurrection Sunday that God we serve, He does not participate with partiality. Can I get a witness? God sent His Son into the world not to condemn any of us, but through His Son Jesus, the Christ the world might be saved. He did not send His Son into the world to save just the Jews, but He came to bring salvation to the entire world, that through His Son Jesus the Christ, we all would have eternal life. Somebody ought to give the Lord some praise. Are you grateful this morning that God sent His Son? Somebody ought to say thank you. If you're grateful that God doesn't show partiality, you ought to give the Lord a shout of praise. I'm so glad this morning the Savior of the world does not favor one group over the next. He loves every one of us, not just here in Canaan, but He loves every man and every woman. And the good news about it, He will judge us all. Somebody ought to say thank you. Our Savior teaches us that His love is not partial. Amen. Anybody get grateful that His love is not partial this morning? Oh, we can do better than that. How many of you know His love is not partial? For while we were yet sinners, Christ Jesus died for us. If you're grateful this morning, you ought to bless His name. He teaches us, even His grace is not partial. Anybody in Canaan grateful for God's grace on your life? Amen. Oh, we can do better than that. How many of you know His grace that covers us? How many of you are grateful that it's God's grace that lifts us up this morning? His grace is not partial. His grace is for everyone. If you don't believe it, ask blind Bartimaeus. He will tell you when everyone kept telling him to be quiet. Can I get a witness? He kept on crying out to God. Can I get a witness? They kept telling him to be quiet. But he realized the Savior of the world had grace that could restore him. And God brought deliverance in his life. Hallelujah. Anybody in Canaan knows what I'm talking about. That grace is available for every man, every woman. It doesn't matter where we find ourselves in life. His grace is sufficient. His salvation is even not partial. Can I get a witness? If you don't believe it, just ask Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus would tell you that Jesus came to him and told him to come down out of the sycamore tree. But everybody else said he was a hated tax collector. Jesus said, come on down. Salvation today is coming to your house. Amen. If you don't believe God, salvation is not partial. Just ask the thief on the cross. Amen. Who heard the words, this day you will be with me in paradise. Can I get a witness? Anybody in Canaan today, you remember the day when you were lost, when everybody else said there was no hope for you? Can I get a witness? But you heard the voice of Jesus telling you, I got work for you. Telling you, I love you, my daughter. I love you, my son. Can I get a witness? I don't act like we receive all our life. Amen. Some of us had our feet under the wrong table. Some of us had our hand in the wrong cookie jar. Can I get a witness? Some of us had some habits going to be to God. Can I get a witness? But by the grace of God, I get a witness to it. But by the grace of God, He's too mighty God for our salvation. Somebody ought to say thank you. Hallelujah. God's healing is even not partial. For He healed the blind. He healed the deaf, the mute, the lame, the brokenhearted, and beyond. And I'm so glad even His witness is not partial. If you don't believe it, just go and ask the Samaritan woman. When Jesus crossed barrier after barrier to witness to her, and by doing so, He brought transformation into her life. The good news in this passage is that Jesus, the Son of the living God, He shows no partiality. He has the same measuring stick for Jeffrey as He does for each one of you. He has the same measure of grace for me as He has for you. Can I get a witness? But we divide. We put up our barriers. Can I get a witness? We show partiality. But God teaches us through His Son, Jesus the Christ, that we all must get rid of partiality. In order to do so, we must get rid of our personal agendas. We got to get rid of those issues that keep us from loving each other. We got to get rid of those issues that keep us from serving with each other. Get rid of those issues that keep us from working with each other. Jesus Christ the Lord teaches us there is no partiality. He loves each one of us. And because of this, I join in with a hymn now with his brother Israel and say, oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Him. All because He first loved me. Aren't you glad this morning that we have a who loves us in spite of. Somebody ought to give the Lord some praise. Hallelujah. Secondly, because Jesus is Lord, we must yield ourselves completely to the Savior. Amen. Too many of us, we want to treat our Savior as a part-time lover. Amen, it's all right. Too many of us want to pick up the Savior only when we feel that it's necessary. Too many of us want to treat the Savior as second fiddle. Well, this is a wake-up call on this Resurrection Sunday. If Jesus Christ is Lord of our lives, he deserves to be first in our lives. If Jesus Christ is Lord of our lives, then he must be first in everything we do. Can I get a witness? Say it in, I'm challenging you to have God first. Don't be afraid. Our Savior wants to know where our allegiance lies. If we claim that he is our Savior, then he wants to be in every decision, in every room of our lives. He does not want us to put a sign up to say you're not welcome. Amen. How many of you know, man, some of us, we have those signs. But he wants to be first. He wants to be in every room of our lives. As one writer stated, unless Jesus Christ is Lord of all, he is not Lord at all. Amen. What does that mean? We can't say he's Lord of our lives and that we welcome where we want him to be. He has to be in every aspect. In our lives, there should be no rivalry, no competition. He wants to be Lord of all. If we claim that he gave his life as a ransom for all, and that he gave his very best, then glory be to God. In return, we need to give God our best and make sure that he is priority in our lives. The Apostle Paul declares, but God demonstrated his own love toward us in that way that while we were yet sinners, he died for us. Our Savior wants us to yield our lives completely to him. He is Lord of our lives. He does not want to be a part-time God. He doesn't just want part of us, but he wants our entire being. He doesn't just want our minds. He wants our souls, Canaan. He wants our heart, Canaan. He wants our entire being. Can I get a witness? I don't know about you, but I want to give my life completely to the Savior. Can I get a witness? I want him to be Lord of my life, the Lord of my circumstances, the Lord of my joys, the Lord of my pains, the Lord of my finances, the Lord of my health, the Lord of my entire being. Do you want him to be yours completely? If you do, you ought to get a Lord some praise. Now tell somebody, I'm sold out. I'm sold out to the Lord. Nothing else really matters. Or if you need it, you ought to bless his name in the flesh. Hallelujah. Now give the Lord of your life. I want you to give the Lord a shout of praise. Don't worry about your neighbor like that. I said, Lord, I thank you for being the Lord of my life. I want to give the glory in this church. Hallelujah. Finally, if Jesus Christ is Lord of our lives, then we have to learn how to surrender to the master in faith. Amen. 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 We got to give it up. Hallelujah. Amen. We got to give it up. Amen. Amen. Even though there were many persons that truly believed that Jesus Christ is Lord, that he was God's anointed one, the Messiah, there were still some who doubted. There were still some who sneered there were still some who had unbelief. There were still some who had mixed emotions of what it meant for Christ to be the Savior of the world and to be the Lord of their lives. There were some who even questioned the fact that he was the Savior of the world. And yet today, we experience the same. Well, my friends, in order for us to get to this point where we fully understand this theological stance, we must have faith. Jesus Christ proved over and over through his works, through his witness, through his association with sinners, how much he loves each one of us, how he wants to be Lord over all of our lives. But yet, many doubted. Yet many were looking for another, because Christ did not fit their perception of a priestly king. As men and women of God, we must step out in faith, believing that he is Lord. No, we were not there that early Sunday morning over 2,000 years ago. No, we were not there with Mary. We were not there with Joanna. We were not there with the other disciples. But our faith in Jesus the Christ, it teaches us, even though we were not there, we believe that he got up with all power, that he is Lord, not just Easter Sunday, but every Sunday morning. Hallelujah. When Jesus, thank you God, met the woman, the Samaritan woman, at the well, and told her everything she had done, she went running to tell everybody, come see a man that told me everything there was to be told in my life. Even though some doubted, they realized transformation came into this woman's life. When the blind man in John 9 met Jesus, and Jesus healed him through faith. Person wanted to know who healed him. The blind man simply said, whether he's a sinner or not, one thing I don't know that, but he said, one thing I do know, I was blind, but now I see. Can I get a witness? It was all because of faith that brought it to this point. Can I get a witness? Know that it takes faith to move God. It takes faith to get our prayers answered. It takes faith to walk in our valley. It takes faith to know that Jesus Christ is Lord. Church, we want Jesus as our Savior. But in order for this to happen, we must learn how to surrender ourselves. Hallelujah. Surrender our attitudes. Surrender our ungodly ways. Surrender our pride. Surrender our jealousy. Surrender our brokenness and the hurts of the world. Surrender our lives and say, Lord, here am I completely give my life to you today. So in closing, I simply ask, is Jesus Christ Lord of our lives? Is he Lord of our thoughts? Is he Lord of our actions? Is he Lord of our relationships? Is he Lord of our finances? Is he Lord of everything that we have? And if not, it's time to make a change. I don't know about you, but I'm glad I'm able to say he is Lord. He is Lord. Do I have a witness in here? He's Lord. Now, if he's Lord of your life, I just want you to stand. Don't worry about who's looking at you. And I just want you to listen to say, Lord, I thank you for being Lord of my life. Don't be afraid. So Lord, I thank you on this Resurrection Sunday that you are Lord of my life. Now, if he's not Lord of your life, hallelujah, it's time to get it right. Can I get a witness? Hallelujah. Now, I want you to tell the Lord, say, Lord, I'm not going to wait until next Easter to say you're Lord of my life. But while I got a chance now, I just want to say I thank you for right now. I thank you, because tomorrow is not promised. Come on and bless the Lord in this way. Now, as the Holy Spirit leads you, I want you to go and challenge somebody in the sanctuary. It's not a time for chit-chat, but I want you to encourage somebody. Say it's time to act like you know who the Lord of your life is. Don't be afraid. Tell your neighbor, I want you to know. Y'all act like y'all scared to move. Amen. Say, neighbor, is he Lord of your life? Is he Lord of your life? Hallelujah. Is the Lord of your life? Hallelujah. He's Lord. So we don't like witnessing each other. But every now and then we need to be encouraged. Every now and then we need to be reminded that he is Lord. Because every day is not the same. Every day. Lord of your life. Hallelujah. Today, after hearing the word of God, maybe there is one who wants to hear his or her life to Christ. I invite you to come. Maybe there is one today who wants to join in as a member, moving to discipleship. Hallelujah. Is there one? It's good to know he is Lord. Hallelujah. Just take a moment and meditate on God's word. And if there is something hindering you from surrender, ask the Lord to help you to move it out of the way. For he wants to be Lord of our life. Hallelujah. He is Lord. He is Lord. Is he Lord of your life? He is risen from the dead. Holding you back from giving your life completely to God. Maybe there is a situation. Maybe there are people who keep telling you, child, you have a lifetime to live. Don't put off today or tomorrow. He wants to be Lord today. If there is one who desires prayer, I invite you to come. Hallelujah. Is there one? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is your time to surrender. What better way to do it than on Resurrection Sunday to get up with new power in Jesus' name? We've done what the Lord has assigned. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm asking Minister Paige if she would come to lead us to the throne of faith.